This video shows you how to add a standard product. Before watching this, we recommend you watch our video, Setting Up Your Products and Inventory in Vend. Let's start by clicking the Add Product button from the Products page. We're going to add a new handbag to our store. First, we can name the product. As covered in our previous video, there are different types of products in Vend, so select the one that applies to the product you're adding. In this case, our handbag doesn't come in any other variations, so let's add this as a standard product. Vend auto-generates a SKU code for you, but you have the option to edit this if required. You can also change the type of code you use to identify your product by selecting the dropdown. We will show you how to add multiple codes a little later in this video. We strongly recommend adding a supply price here, as this calculates the average cost of your product when you bring your inventory in for the first time. This also becomes a default value when creating purchase orders in Vend, but you can easily edit this when required. We have purchased this handbag for $45 per unit, so let's enter that here as our supply price. The final step now is to add the retail price and click Create Product. Once this product has been created, you will land on the Edit Product page. On here, you can add more information to the product you have just created, or you click Add Another Product in the banner above. Let's take a look at adding more information to this product. We can select from our current list of brands or add a new one if necessary. The description field is useful for retailers selling online, as this will be the customer-facing description for your product. Because we are not selling online, we will leave this field blank for now. Product tags are a low-level categorization of your product. These are really useful for filtering and reporting within Vend and can also be used if you are selling online to organize search results on your website. In this case, I would like to add the materials used. This handbag is made of leather, so I'll add that as a tag. The product type is the high-level categorization of our product, so let's add it to the accessories product type. This categorization is also useful for filtering and reporting within Vend. Next, you can add images to your product so employees have a visual reference for the item. These are also important for retailers selling online so your customers can see what they are buying. If you need to add more than one code to your product, simply click the Add Another Code button and add the details. All of these codes are scannable within Vend, but only the first SKU code will be shown to staff and customers when previewing the product or printing on receipts. Next, we have the option to add a supplier name and a supplier code that is used to identify the product and a supply price. You will see Track Inventory has been turned on for this product by default. But if the product you are selling is a service, then we recommend turning inventory tracking off. We have now reached our inventory section. As covered in the previous video, if you are setting up your products for the first time and are not yet making sales in Vend, we recommend adding your inventory in right before you begin selling with Vend. Because I am adding all my products in advance, I will leave this field blank for now. Next, you can add your reorder points and reorder quantities. These allow you to keep on top of your stock quantities and manage your ordering processes easier. For our handbag, I want to reorder more when I have only 3 left in my store, and I want to reorder 10 at a time, so I will put these quantities in here. Next, I will assign a tax rate to my product. Vend has selected my store's default tax, which is great. But if you have a specific tax you need to assign to this product, you can select it from the dropdown. Just remember, you will need to set up these taxes in the Setup tab to have them appear in this list. If you have loyalty enabled for your store, then you can see the loyalty option is set to a certain value based on your store-wide earning ratio. I'm going to change this to $3 for this product as an incentive to sell more from the get-go. Let's now save this product and see it is viewable on our products page. On this page, you can easily search for products or filter or export to CSV. Let's go to the next video now, adding products with variants.